As you know, the mission of Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam to purify ourselves. And tonight is very important part from Hadith. Alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Man taraka shay'an lillahi, awwadahu Allahu khayran min." If we leave anything sake of Allah, Allah will replace you better than it. And our scholars give us a lot of examples. Imagine Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. When his people in Iraq gave him hard time, he said, فَقَالَ إِنِّي مُهَاجِرٌ إِلَى رَبِّي. And he left Iraq to what? Palestine and Mecca. Better than Iraq. Okay? And the companion Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, when he gave them hard time, imagine Zubayr. Zubayr radiallahu anhu, when he immigrated from Mecca to Medina, he broken. Zero. Nothing. When he passed away, you know, if you pass away, your wife take 1/8 from your money. When he passed away, he has 4 wives. Okay? And the 4 wives share in 1/8, Asma take it millions and 200. Imagine how many millions he has, Zubayr ibn Awam, radiallahu anhu. Because he left everything in Mecca, sick of Allah. An immigrant, sick of Allah, and Allah gave him better than whole dunya. Now, reality now. I know one brother, his mom passed away. May Allah forgive her. And all his brothers attack her money as hungry dogs. When his brother go to his mom, passed away, take all jewelry. Must cry, your mom passed away. No, you need money. You need everything. And you take it. And one brother, mashallah, he tried to practice Islam, but real Islam. Because, understand, some people practice real Islam, some people only pray. It's different to Allah, 100% is different. Real Islam, you must listen to God, what He said, to everything, and you must try for the Prophet Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam. The prayer, something between you and God. And Allah knows, Allah accepts from us now or not. Allah knows, when you start to say, Allahu Akbar, you think about God, or you think about dunya, Allah knows. But really Islam, his brother tried to practice Islam and he looked at his brother and said, calm down. We must bury our mom first. He said, no. We need money. Everyone take some money. After a while, his brother said, okay, I take all my money, give to my sisters and you. Take it. No problem to me. After 3-4 years, mashallah, his brother be multimillionaire. And another brother, broken, came to him and said, please give us. And he reminded them, remember, when I said, leave something sake of Allah, but everyone attack money, attack jewelry, only focus. And our Prophet, why he said that? If you leave our desires sake of Allah, any desires, if your shaitan come to you, or desire, or your shahwa, and you leave it sake of Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replace you in your heart, something better. What's the better? Real iman. Imagine if the pretty woman in your job, you want to look to her, it said, no, I must don't look to her. Why? Because Allah commanded me that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you real iman. It's reality. Now, if you want a revenge from your parents or from your relative, leave it, sake of Allah. Say, no, I must forgive. As a Muslims, must forgive each other and forget. But nafs and the shaitan come to you and said to you, no, you must revenge. No. As a Muslim, I'm not believe revenge. I believe forget and forgive. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us, all of us, real iman. Say ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understand the Quran, then follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Make salah upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as much as you can. Jazakumullah khair. Ameen.